Heroes in Cuba, convicted spies right here in the United States. Do they deserve to be in prison right now tonight? A powerful debate on their case and their fate. I'm Wolf Blitzer. You're in the Situation Room. Tonight's spy case, five Cuban men behind bars here in the United States. They say they were getting information on potential terrorists in Miami. The U.S. government says they were playing a deadly game of espionage. Stay with us. You're in the Situation. We'll have the story of five Cuban men hailed in their country as heroes in the fight against terrorism. So why are they serving long prison sentences right now in the United States? Stay with us. You're in the Situation Room. To some people, they're spies, but to Cubans, they're heroes. We're going to have a debate about the group that they call in Cuba, the Cuban Five. Stick around. You're in the Situation. In our look around the world right now, depending on who's talking, they're either brave patriots who wanted to defend their country against terrorism, or they're shady figures determined to inflict damage on the United States. Five Cuban men in prison here in the United States, some serving life sentences. Some people are calling them the Cuban Five. Their country holds them up as icons. CNN's Morgan Neal explains from Havana. Morgan?
Well, federal appeals judges in Atlanta are going over a spy case that's barely made the back pages of the papers. But here in Cuba, the smallest details of the case are front page news.
In Cuba, they're known on a first name basis. Gerardo, Ramon, Antonio, Fernando, and Rene. They're called the Cinco Héroes, the five heroes, and they're the center of a long-running government-sponsored campaign. Their case doesn't provoke the passions of the Elian Gonzalez saga, the Cuban boy at the center of an emotional cross-border custody battle in 2000. But even school kids on the island know the case of the Cinco inside and out. Eight years ago, the five men were arrested in Miami on spying charges. All were convicted of acting as unregistered foreign agents and conspiracy to commit crimes against the United States. Three were also found guilty of conspiracy to commit espionage. Cuba says the men weren't spying on the U.S. government, but on what Cuba calls terrorist organizations run by exiles out of Miami.
Contra el terrorismo.
The president of Cuba's National Assembly says they're heroes. In his words, whose only fault was to fight against terrorism. Cuba says it was impossible for them to get a fair trial in Miami. Three of the five received life sentences, the other two, 15 and 19 years. Now they await a new ruling on whether the evidence in their case supports their convictions. We met with Olga Salanueva, whose husband Rene Gonzalez is serving a 15-year sentence. She was deported from the United States 2 years after his arrest and has been denied a visa ever since. The last time I saw Rene was the day I was detained, she says, August 16th, 2000. It's been 7 years since I saw him. When we arrive, Olga is at a reunion of her husband's flight school classmates. Then her phone rings. It's her husband calling from prison.
Hola, Rene. Habla Morgan.
She passes the phone so we can talk. From the start, it was a political show, Rene tells me. We were simply defending our country. To this point, the courts have not agreed.
Now, these men have been behind bars for some 9 years, but they're definitely not forgotten here in Cuba. In fact, they're so well known, billboards here read simply, "They will return." And everyone knows who they are. Wolf?